Priya and I'm a student of SBU School and Junior College, Chennai. Reading has always been my most favorite thing to do. I'm a voracious reader and a logophile. That's probably why writing has blossomed into being my passion. I find that by writing, I can express myself more openly and eloquently. Today I wish to present before you my short story, Breathe, which was shortlisted for the national level story writing competition conducted by Novella. But before I do that, I'd like to give you a short gist of the story. The story revolves around the life of Janet, who is a workaholic and takes too much pressure upon herself. What happens when she breaks under the strain and how she copes with the stress is what forms the crux of the story. Now, let's jump into the story. It was a fine Sunday morning, the most anticipated day of the week. Naturally, everyone was outside, killing time. Some lazily reading with a cup of chai in hand, some hitting the gym to burn the guilty calories of the previous week's not-so-healthy food, and yet others still in a blissful state of sleep. The sun was shining, birds were chirping. It was a glorious day for everyone. Well, everyone excepting Janet. Janet was all of 20, but very unlike others of her age. While her peers would probably be hanging out with friends or even enjoying on their own, Janet considered all of this to be a waste of time. She was the very embodiment of properness and perfection. All her life she had lived with a set of rules. Her life was organized and structured. For her, the only thing of prime importance in life was to work hard and earn lots. And who could blame her? Hailing from quite a traditional family, she had four older brothers and had always been looked down upon by them. Perhaps it was because she was the only girl in the family or because she was the youngest, but she hated being treated like a baby. So, she had always strived to be better than them at everything. She loved to do things that would prove that she was tough. So, here she was on a holiday at her desk in the office, working overtime. She was an accountant for a large IT firm. Even after repeated persuasion from her own boss, she refused to take a break from work. Consequently, at the young age of 20, she already had a few grays in her hair. She considered her work with a kind of reverence, and as a result, she was the best at it. In the 2 years of her career, she had already been promoted thrice. Such was her brilliance. She could calculate the most hectic of figures within seconds and had a solution to almost everything. She was mocked as a know-it-all by her colleagues, but she didn't care. She was undeterred from her goal. Usually, Janet didn't mind working overtime at all, but she had been up all night attending the call of a client from another country. So, she was currently very exhausted. There were bags under her eyes and her face showed clear signs of tiredness. The prim and proper Janet, who always sat upright and often scolded others scathingly for not doing so, was slumping onto her desk. And for the very first time in her life, she felt she couldn't take it any longer. She was stressed. She walked up to the large glass window overlooking the roads with a flask of coffee in her hand. And for the very first time in her life, looking at the people below her, she wanted to be like them. All of a sudden, her work felt so burdensome and all she wanted to do was to run from the confines of that building. She felt suffocated from the inside. She was confused about why she was feeling this way. She mentally reprimanded herself for letting such a thought cross her mind. But after 10 more minutes of cooling herself, she decided that enough is enough. So, she called up the only person in the world with whom she felt she could share anything. Her mother, Rebecca. Rebecca was the one who knew Janet better than anyone else. While others thought of her as odd and aloof, she thought of her daughter as extraordinary. It was true that she did not like Janet working herself up all the time, but knew that she was doing something she loved. So Janet rung her up and confessed everything. Her stressed mind, her confused feelings, all of it. After patiently listening to Janet, Rebecca's verdict was this: "You are clearly overworked." When she heard this, she was incredulous. "But I hardly work," was a much too modest protest. But Rebecca relented. "Hear me out," she said. "You've been working day and night. I'm pretty sure that you haven't slept in days. Come on, Janet. When was the last time you actually enjoyed yourself?" This got her thinking. She realized that almost all her life, she had worried too much about what others would think, about how she could be the best. And in this process, she had completely forgotten about really living life. "I enjoy working," Janet replied, even though she herself knew it wasn't completely true. "Come on, Janet, don't lie to yourself. If you don't take a break, I'm afraid of what might happen to you." "But," Janet protested, "listen to me just this once. I've told you many times before and I'm telling you again. Take a break, let loose, and breathe free." Somehow, she managed to convince Janet. The first thing Janet did was to apply for a long leave of 1 week. Her boss was extremely surprised that the only employee in the company who has never once taken a leave was applying for a whole week now. But deciding that she deserved it, he readily agreed. So Janet, who usually worked well into the night, was leaving the office at around 11 a.m. Janet had thought she would regret her decision, but she actually felt better already. She was suddenly feeling very relaxed. There was no other word to describe that. She looked up at the sky. Dark clouds had begun to dot the clear blue. Winds were blowing and it began to drizzle. A drop touched her cheek and she felt as though she were born again. Very soon, the heavens were pouring. The old Janet would hurriedly open her umbrella and seek shelter, but now she simply threw her umbrella away and spread her arms wide as if to embrace the rain. She wanted to experience it now. She wanted to experience everything. Never had she felt so wonderful. She felt this was the beginning of a new chapter in her life. Her senses had been awakened. She was finally learning to live life afresh and cherish the little things. She was finally learning to breathe. Thank you for listening to the story. If you like the story, don't forget to click on the link given in the description below and log on to novella.co.in to like my story. Also review it if you can. Thank you.